Hey folks, I'm going to prove that baking soda and cornbread mix kills rats. It also kills squirrels. We'll be right back. Hey, welcome back to Pine Meadows Hobby Farm. I'm your host, Jerry Hansen. I produced this epic video on kill rats dead with baking soda and cornbread mix. I only use the cornbread mix as an attractant. You guys can use other products besides cornbread mix. You could use cake mix, biscuit mix, anything that will attract a rodent, or anything you find in your cupboards that rodents are getting into, use that because they're after it. But also I wanted to stress that you join it with equal parts baking soda, and the baking soda is what's going to actually kill the rodent. What it does is it goes into their gut, it mixes with their stomach acid, and it starts bubbling. And since a rodent's digestive tract is a little bit complex, it's longer than a normal, the other animals' digestive systems, it builds up faster than they can actually flatulate it out. And since rodents don't have the muscle structure to be able to burp or regurgitate their air that's built up, they ended up perforating their insides, and they don't blow up as you would imagine. Beep, pop goes the weasel. No, that's not what's happening. So since I produced that video, I've been getting a lot of questions. Does this work on chipmunks and voles and squirrels? Yes, it does. I'm going to prove that it works on a squirrel because I live trapped a squirrel last night and I put it in this cage. I feed it. I have it some water. I'm also feeding it some cornbread mix and baking soda equal parts, about 4 tablespoons of each in this little bowl that I put in there. So that's all it has to eat. I put a trail cam up. We're going to sit there and watch it and see how effective it is and how fast it does. I advocate, though, it does work because I've been keeping the infestation under control on my farm. See, we live in the wilderness. I have animal feed. We're going to attract rodents because they're opportunistic. They're looking for warmth and shelter. They're also looking for food, and I have plenty of food here. I'm having a rodent problem right now in my bunny bungalow. I have some different traps out. None of them are working yet. So I'm getting ready to set the cornbread mix out to see if I can diminish the population. Now I stress, you're not going to get rid of rodents, period. There's billions and trillions of rodents out in the population. They are procreating like rodents and they're coming in. But once you get rid of the rodents within your environment, this is a method to safely get rid of them, because this stuff is safe for your animals so long as it's mixed in small quantities, because it's not enough to harm your chickens or your dogs or your cats. And even if, you know, beneficial wildlife come in contact with it, it won't harm them. And if your chickens, because yeah, chickens are omnivores, they do eat rats and mice, they will not be harmed by eating a rodent that has been killed by this stuff, as opposed to some poisons. Many of my viewers are complaining that the poisons that are on the market are killing their dogs that have gotten either into the bait or eaten a rodent that got the bait, and also the beneficial wildlife. I have owls here that eat the wildlife. I have fox here. I have possums. I have a possum family in my tractor barn. I'm okay with that because they are immune to a rattlesnake bite, so they will eat rattlesnakes. So they eat rodents. They're very beneficial to have on the farm, except they eat my chicken eggs, and it's my responsibility to keep my eggs safe away from these predators, especially these beneficial predators, wildlife, I don't mind them. So I got this little guy set up here in a cage that he can't escape from. And out here in the shade, later today I'll come in as the sun moves and put some more shade over him. But like I said, I gave him some water, and we do have some cornbread mix with equal parts baking soda in this food dish when it gets hungry. And I do have the trail cam focused on to see if he's eating it and when he finally expires. I know it's mean and cruel, but a lot of people are desiring proof, evidence that it's working. I want proof, like you do. The only proof I have is the absence of the rodents that once I had the problem with. I put the Jiffy cornbread mix and the baking soda out, and the rodents are gone. I do have an odor. When they were trapped in the house, they died in the walls, but that stink only lasts for 10 days. So it did take about 6 hours for the baking soda to work once he ate it. Unfortunately, it has a two-prong effect on the rodent. Number one is the baking soda, which is a base, it will have an effect with the stomach acid. You don't need to add water. It just mixes with their juices, their own stomach acids, and it reacts. Try putting baking soda in a little cup of vinegar. Yeah, same reaction. Anyway, vinegar is an acid, baking soda is a base. Sodium bicarbonate, that's what it is. It's a natural product. It causes bloating in the stomach, and so much so that it perforates their innards. Also, it's an alkali. The rodent's system cannot handle the alkalinity in its system, so its organs start shutting down. So there's a two-prong effect that is dispatching the rodents. There are at least two websites I found out there. One is biotech termite and pest .com, and they looked at the question. They apparently did their research, and they said yes, it does work. And this is obvious because this is evidence. There's another .org website that I looked at, and it's rat poison fat. Check that out. They also validated that, yeah, it works. And it's obvious. It works. It also works on moles, voles, rats, mice, well, any of the rodent family. Does not work on raccoons, does not work on skunks, does not work on possums. And I don't know about armadillos. It probably won't work on an armadillo because I don't think they're of the rodent family. But you might want to do your own research on that, because I did get some questions and from the people from the southern United States that do have armadillos. We don't have them up here in Oregon. I've never seen one, so I don't know anything about it. Well, I'm your host, Jerry Hansen. This is Pine Meadows Hobby Farm, where frugal homestead tucked high in the Cascade Ranges of the Pacific Northwest. Please stay tuned to more videos. I hope this answers your questions and demonstrating that, yes, it does work. Baking soda does a lot of things, and this is one. Leave a comment, give us a thumbs up, share this video on your social media platforms. It helps grow the channel and introduces this safe method to others. And it is safe to beneficial wildlife. And that's what I'm an advocate. Save your kitties, save your dogs, save the beneficial wildlife, because they help keep the rodent population under control. And if you're poisoning them with bad poisons that end up killing the beneficial livestock and wildlife, that's a bad thing. Anyway, something cheap, something natural, give it a try. Be safe, always be kind. I'll see you guys in the next adventure. Bye-bye now.